Good morning. I'm Dr. Ashwani Kumar, psychiatrist at Santulan in Delhi and Gurgaon. This morning we'll be talking about a very important issue which is usually neglected. In another communication, we had mentioned about the common habits, common behavioral issues which are just passed on as habits. So, of course, those are the things which are very common but are taken to be habits. So, it's understandable to ignore them for a long time. But I am surprised that even very serious issues which are life threatening are usually ignored by the ignorant family members. What I am talking about is anybody in the family expressing any death wish or planning to do any self-harm or actually indulging in self-harm. These are things which are still in our families, in our culture, very commonly neglected. That, okay, this is a mistake somebody has done in the family, and we are very sure that on its own the person will realize and not indulge in any behavior again. But the scientific studies say that before any person completes the suicide, there is at least one or two attempts at deliberate self-harm. A very rare case, somebody who completes the suicide has attempted it for the first time. It's very rare that somebody who completes suicide has not expressed the death wishes to somebody in the family or in the friend circle. But what happens is that any expression of death wishes is usually brushed aside very lightly. Brushing aside any expression of death wish can be as fatal a mistake as ignoring chest pain. What happens when there is a chest pain in any of the loved one? We definitely make sure that this person, this loved one, is investigated thoroughly by the experts on this, so that they can make it out whether this chest pain is muscular or it is a sign of impending heart attack. Because if we make a diagnosis ourselves, we can make a mistake. But if an expert makes a diagnosis, the likelihood of making a mistake is much less. So before coming to a conclusion that this chest pain is to be ignored, it is just acidity or muscular pain, we do get the person investigated by the expert. Because ignoring it can be a fatal mistake. So similarly, when there is a death wish, the expert, after talking to the person in the family who has expressed such a wish or who has made an attempt, can come to a diagnosis what kind of psychiatric issue can be there. See, there are times when the risk of attempting suicide is very, very high, and there are proper instruments, the tools which can make that assessment possible. So it's always in the interest of the family members and friends that if any of the loved ones expresses this kind of wishes or indulges in any self-harm, then he or she should be encouraged to meet a psychiatrist so that a proper evaluation can be made, so that an action plan can be chalked out, so that the person who had expressed any wish like this or who had indulged in self-harm in whatever way, something can be done for this person, and the probability of this person indulging in a similar behavior or more risky behaviors can go down. Now, many of us will believe that will it make the person more stigmatized if he or she is told that you have made an attempt, so you should be seen by a psychiatrist. No, it doesn't increase the stigma on this person, because like in any other health issue, the disease or the intensity of the symptom should be taken due diligence of, and an expert should be roped in to see whether the symptom can be ignored or it is sign of a disease. And if it is sign of a disease, then the treatment for that disease should be initiated. So, I very strongly encourage all of you that in case any of the loved ones in the family or in the friend circle indulges in any behavior like this, it should not be brushed aside, it should be taken more seriously, and the person should be encouraged to go for evaluation to a psychiatrist so that the intensity of the issue can be judged scientifically. Thank you.